But yeah, my name is Major Slacker. Your name is Hardcore Slacker number, however many subscribers I have right now, plus one. This is my real walkthrough of Doom. This is a practiced and studied walkthrough, and this is level two. The official name is Resource Operations.
Hello, I am Vega, the sentient intelligence assigned to Mars. After running diagnostics on the Praetor suit, it appears that I can activate optional challenges that, when completed, will assist in upgrading your arsenal at an accelerated pace. I have added a tracking component to your dossier.
There we go. We now have mission challenges introduced to each mission. Complete a challenge and you get a free weapon upgrade point. Some of them are really, how should we say, a pain in the ass. Anyways, there's three of them. Two for variety is the spice of life and quite the explorer. And this level, variety is the spice of life, is a tough one. Twofer. Use a shotgun to kill two possessed in one shotgun blast. Explosive shot is allowed. Variety is the spice of life. Get five different glory kills on possessed. Those five different glory kills have to be from the front, side, rear, above, and against the wall. I'll get to more about that in a minute. Right now I'm going to try to position two of these possessed close enough together so I can get the shotgun blast on them right boom there. So we killed two possessed with one shotgun blast. That completes the twofer challenge and we get a weapon point for that. Let's do a glory kill on this guy. That is a front glory kill. Come at him from the front. Once you come out here, two imps spawn. One spawns right there. We use the barrel to blow him away. Another one spawns down there, except a poor possessed was in the way and I mistook him for an imp. So I blew away a chance to do a glory kill there. Anyways, a little trigger happy. This needs some power, so we have to go down this way to get some power. Pry open these doors and you meet a whole bunch more possessed. Use these guys to get more glory kills. That was another friend, so that didn't count. Let's try to get a side glory kill or against the wall glory kill. That's against the wall glory kill, so now that's two. That was above. To get above, just whack him, put him into stagger mode, jump up and do the glory kill while you're in the air. Make sure you blow away that imp at the end there. Against the wall is probably the finickiest one, the toughest one to do. Behind is kind of a pain in the ass too, because they turn around pretty quick. So you might have to take one for the team, like I just did, to get in position to do this. That's the thing about these challenges, they really endanger you, eh? Sometimes it's not worth it. I have to tell you right away, here's how you reset the power, hit the switch here. I have to tell you right away, this is not going to be a 100% walkthrough, okay? Probably more like a 99% walkthrough. We'll get into more of that in a minute.
I believe in honesty, especially now, in what will be your final moments in this world. All the rumors, the human sacrifices, the hell portal, the demons, it's all true. My sisters and brothers, be thankful. You will be the first. You will have a seat alongside them, just as I will, in what will become the new world that they create for us. Starting now.
There we go, some nice happy thoughts from Skankzilla. Thank you very much. Let's hit up the auto map station to give it to you right away. So you can fill up the whole map right away. Boom, there we go. Once again, blue is where you've been, gray is where you have not been, alright? Before you take off, make sure you get the first secret right here. Turn around, jump up here, hang a right, drop down.
Especially now.
Shimmy around here, grab that arm and you get a secret. Okay, and that counts towards one of the challenges, quite the explorer. We have to get three secrets, okay? Let's continue, we've got everything powered up, we can now take that cargo elevator down. So let's go hit the switch. Hit the switch and we have one final glory kill to get. A side glory kill, which I often confuse with an up against the wall glory kill. Because, the approach is very similar. So there we go, I completed that challenge. all five different glory kills, front, side, rear, above, and up against the wall. Okay, so we get another weapon point for that. We're saving those weapon points. Onward. Take care of these possessed any way you like. Use either the pistol or do a double smackdown on them. That is melee and then glory kill. Don't waste shotgun ammo on them. An imp always spawns there. Charge up an energy shot with your pistol and blow them away. Another imp spawns just below that armor up there. Try again, Slack. Attaboy. Now, two more imps spawn down near the end here. Just go down near the end, all the way to the end. Blow away this guy, do an about face. Blow away this guy, and you got a couple of zombies off to your right here. Switch to your pistol. Or do a melee attack, a double smackdown. And here we have a classic map door. We have to find the lever to open that door. Let's go find it. Just return this way. Find these crates. Jump up in these crates. We're going to have to do a little bit of platforming. Grab that armor there. You got to kind of jump up here. And up here. And the lever is right there. Yank on that lever. Get the funny ringing sound, and the classic map door is open. All you have to do is go in the classic map a little bit and you discover the secret. Let's blow away these two possessed soldiers there with a little bit of bouillabaisse. Finish them off with an explosive shot. This is just a tiny bit of a classic map. They don't really give you much this time. Compared with the next level, they give you a lot. They give you a huge portion of the classic map. Okay, so that's that. That's two secrets now we've got. Up ahead, we're going to meet a new kind of enemy known as the Possessed Engineer. They kind of like a suicide guy, that guy right there. Make sure you blow him away. And we're going to come up to another lockdown here. Find the best way to do this lockdown is rush up, blow away that imp right there. Blow that barrel, throw in a grenade over there. Boom, that takes care of that Possessed Engineer, or Possessed Soldier rather. Doing about face. Sometimes an imp spawns down here, but anyways, go back here anyways, rather, to get another grenade. And doing that Possessed Soldier there. It's kind of like two waves. Two waves of Possessed Soldiers and imps. So that's the first wave down. Now it's just Possessed, just these zombie-like guys, until you get up near the back, okay? Now that we're near the back, the imp spawns and another Possessed Engineer is going to spawn behind me. Right there. Boom. Once you've got him down, there's just one more imp to take care of. And then the zombies. So that's a quick way to do this area. Once you know what spawns and where they spawn, you know, you can just have your way with them. Okay, picking off a few scragglers here in the form of zombies. Pretty soon. There we go. Checkpoint reached. So let's make the rounds, get some armor, health, and ammo, powder our noses before we continue. Now, we can get some armor by hitting this switch here. This will stop these kind of like... They're not really like elevators. They're just like these boxes that fly by all the time. If you hit that switch, that'll stop these boxes. And then you could do some platforming to get up here. Up here and up here. Grab some goodies there. Go up on the little gangplank there. And you can get into this room here and get some armor. 50 armor. And jump down into this room and get the chainsaw. Yeah, all together now. Woohoo! Yeah, the chainsaw. Yeah. This is the baby that you want. Yeah. Runs on fuel. We get three bars of fuel to start. And you can improve that by putting points into the ammo category of argent cells, right? out to this section here, blow away that barrel there, right, boom, there, throw a grenade down there, back out, make sure you blow this barrel here, hook up your chainsaw, and go after only possessed soldiers, or imps. There's an imp, that's all, that's worth using the chainsaw on. There we go, take down the soldier, because those are the, you know, the guys that are real pain in the arse there. There's another soldier. So that's our chainsaw fuel used up. Make sure you use up your chainsaw in this area because you get more fuel right away. If you don't use it, you wasted it. Seriously. Viewers are always talking about wasting ammo. To me, ammo is only wasted when you don't use it. And that was a health station that you saw me go up against there. I didn't need health, but if you need health, you can go up to that, interact with it, and it will fill up your health completely, no matter how piss poor you've been doing. Yeah, if you're at 1% health, it'll fill up completely. Okay, so next, get that chainsaw fuel there. Fill that up. Go across the moving box tramway there. Go into this, make sure you don't go in while it's closing up. Travel up here, get some more armor if you need it. Hunker down into the maintenance tunnel. Go around here, hang it right here, and drop down into kind of like a security office. Alright? Bunch of zombies here. Don't waste good ammo on them. Pistol or melee attacks. Keep practicing your headshots, eh? Because we're going to be doing a lot of them next level. So start practicing right now, like I told you in the beginning. Practice headshots. So there's some chainsaw ammo. Chainsaw fuel, rather. Keep that in mind. So the next area you go into, make sure you use your chainsaw again, because there's more fuel right here. If you don't use your chainsaw, you're wasting it. Right? So we need the yellow key for that security office right there. This is locked, okay? Take note of that. Pry this open. And this will take us into the first gore nest here. Watch out for zombies that might ambush you as soon as you come out. Same deal here. Pistol or melee attacks. Don't use a shotgun unless you're really mad. There's a shotgun, you motherfucker. Don't forget to exploit explosive barrels. So here's a gore nest. As long as you hear the groaning, there's still some of these zombies left alive, right? Alright, all quiet on the western front. Gore nest! Gonna show you a nice standoff point here. So you got a chainsaw, you got your shotgun with explosive shot. Right here, perfect standoff point, okay? You're gonna use the chainsaw on possessed soldiers and use the shotgun on imps, right? Activate the gore nest, go to your standoff point, turn to the left there, boom. Make sure you get that guy. Another one spawns there. Whenever you get a chance to do a glory kill, do it, because it'll give you health. There's a possessed soldier, he gets the chainsaw treatment. Back to your standoff point, rinse and repeat. Explosive shot on the imps, chainsaw on the possessed soldiers. There's a soldier right there. Let's whip out the chainsaw and introduce him to the cutting edge. All right. Rinse and repeat. I initially thought there was just 4 possessed soldiers in this area. There's actually 5. So you got enough to take down 3 with your chainsaw. There we go. Now my chainsaw is empty. Now it's all explosive shot all the way. But stay in this standoff point. It's a nice safe place. At one point they rush you, I've noticed this, eh? So they all rushed me. So they kind of flush you out of your standoff point. That's okay, their numbers are greatly depleted, so you should be able to manage this no problem. And that's it. This area. Down and out. The way you continue is to go to the elevator to my... Right there. I'll do that in a second. I just want to ammo up. All right, call down the elevator. This will take us up to the yellow key. That's our current objective, find the yellow access key. That's going to open up everything. This is also going to take us to the field drone, which we're not going to use. There's the field drone right there. Not going to use it. Okay, I'm going to save it for the heavy assault rifle. Alright, we only get one field drone on this level, so I'm going to save it. There's the yellow access key. Now watch it. He's just playing possum, so as soon as you take the key off him, he gets a little upset. And, he loses his head. Go through the maintenance only door. Watch out for an imp at the end. Explosive shot his ass, drop down the hatch, and this will put us right in front of the original yellow door that we were locked out of. But before you go there, climb up these crates here. We're going to discover some secrets. Wait for the containers to pass, otherwise you're going to get squashed. And by squashed, I mean die a horrible death. And we can go into the security office. Okay, security station, grab some goodies, and hit the switch to unlock everything. That switch right there. Basically cancels the lockdown. So that hatch I showed you previously, don't forget to get the chainsaw fuel, that's very important. The hatch I showed you previously right here is now open. Make sure you go down there to discover some secrets. Drop down, get ready to rock and roll. I am using the shotgun on these zombies here, but it's worth it because there's an imp down there. Alright, so grab this Praetor token off this elite guard. We only have one token. The next upgrade I want to get costs two tokens, so we'll leave that for now. Just show you where I am on the map. Right, do an about face. Go through R01.2. Hang a left, go up here. Climb up here, hang a right, and grab the plasma rifle. Boya. Yeah, kick-ass weapon. We're going to upgrade that later. The star of the show on this level is going to be the heavy assault rifle. That's what we're saving all our weapon points for, and the field drone for. Alright, so back out, go across the hatch, hang it right here, kick out that grate, and we're back in the gore nest room, okay? Now we're going to take the elevator up again. Take the elevator up. Go back to that same area where we discovered the field drone. Calm down, Slack. You're going to get to use the plasma rifle soon enough. And we're going to go into another secret area. Okay? Go here. There's the field drone. Hang a left. There. Open this, or go through that gate there. And follow this hallway down here. Find this little tunnel here. Hunker down. Go down into the tunnel, hang left at the end, and drop into this room here. That's a secret. Boom. And there's another Praetor token there. So now we have 6 out of 8 secrets. And an armor 50 there. That's good. And a Praetor token. A Praetor token, rather. Praetor suit token. Now we have 2 tokens, we can spend them. Spend them, Slack. Slack. Go to environmental resistance. What are you doing? Looking at your notes? Okay, I looked at my notes. Self-preservation is the next one. And the next one, barrels of fun. You definitely want that. That's going to cost 3 tokens. So we're going to get that next level. Self-preservation protects you against your own weapon damage. Very important when using explosive shot. Okay, so hit that switch there. Turn to the right. Find the original yellow door that you were locked out of. Go through it. Go in here and find the heavy assault rifle, one of my favorite weapons in the game, right? Pick that sucker up. Learn it. Love it. We're now gonna go back, okay? And get a mod for it. We have no mods. All the mods are locked out. We're now gonna finally spend the field drone. So back to the gore nest area. Drop down, take the elevator up, and we're gonna use the field drone on this heavy assault rifle. And we're gonna get the tactical scope. I can't tell you how much easier this is gonna make the game. If you're not a runner and gunner, if you're not like, you know, some kind of like wild and crazy multiplayer spastic, you know, rip-roaring run and gunner, get this mod. Get this weapon and get this mod. It's gonna make the game a whole lot easier, okay? It's basically gonna turn the assault rifle into a sniper rifle. Right? So, field drone, tactical scope on the assault rifle, heavy assault rifle. Yes, please. Thank you very much. And we have a whole bunch of weapon points. We can start upgrading this mod right away. Let's spend those points. Over to the arsenal screen. Tactical scope. I strongly recommend that you get Skullcracker right away. This will make headshots do more damage and get lightweight. This will allow you to move at full speed or a lot faster when you have the weapon scoped, okay? And we'll get this one next level, your radium coating. That's gonna cost a whopping 5 points, but it's definitely worth it because once we get that, it's gonna unlock the mastery challenge. All right, and I'll tell you about that next level. That's it for this video, though. I want to thank you very much for watching. Part 2 is coming up tomorrow. Part 2 of level 2 is coming up right away tomorrow. If you thought this video was remotely entertaining and or informative, please subscribe to my channel to get more videos like this hot off the press. Yeah. All right. See you next video.